Hey, I'm Jim Weber, the Fox 13 Weather Center. Thanks for logging on to MyFoxHurricane.com. So we continue to watch potential tropical cyclone number 6. Hurricane reconnaissance plane, they were flying in the system this morning. And as you look at the enhanced satellite loop, you're seeing there's quite a bit of convection with this. It's probably actually looking a little better organized than it was yesterday at this time. But even though you're seeing that, one of the things they found was it still lacks that well-defined center of circulation. Now, there's several different criteria that you have to have in a system to classify it as a tropical system, and one of them is a well-defined center of circulation. They did not find that. They did find some winds up to tropical storm force, so it has some of the elements, it just doesn't have all of the elements. But they give it that designation, potential tropical cyclone, just because it's close to it or it's interacting with land areas. And so you want to get that extra warning time out to people. Let them know that we have a system out there that could very quickly change status. So you put that designation now that they've had for several years now, potential tropical cyclone. Now, you look at the water vapor imagery, you are seeing some drier air surrounding the system, and there are some signs that maybe some mid-level dry air is being pulled in on that southern side. You get some of that dry air being pulled in, and it kind of chokes it off a little bit. So I think at least in the short term, it will continue to at least struggle somewhat because the dry air and also interacting with some land areas. It'll continue to work its way on towards that west-northwesterly direction. So as it does so, it's just going to continue to deal with more and more of these land areas. You've got Puerto Rico, you have Hispaniola, you also have Cuba. So it will be dealing with some of that. Once it makes its way into the Gulf of Mexico, if it survives all that, then it looks like it'll start to get into some open water, very warm water as well. And that's when, if we're going to see some intensification, that's that open road where we can actually start to see more and more of that intensification. But remember, the forecast track, we're getting better and better at that. But that intensity forecast continues to be something that we struggle with. Right now, winds are at 35 miles an hour. It's moving towards the west-northwest at 18 miles an hour. So forecast track really hasn't changed all that much, which no reason to change that. We've got the strong high sitting to the north of this system. So there's just no reason to actually change the thought process. There's the high sitting to the north. And so it basically it just kind of rounds right around that high. That's what we're seeing. But you notice as we get into the Gulf of Mexico, as it works its way in right through here, notice those winds, 45 miles an hour up to 60 miles an hour. So it's getting into some open water, gets room to actually intensify. And there's plenty of warm water in the Gulf of Mexico. So if we're going to see something, that would be a very good spot to see some intensification. You look at all the various computer models, and still very tightly clustered. You get a little bit of a spread into the Gulf of Mexico, but still that same general idea of this system working its way into the Eastern Gulf, it looks like as we head into the weekend. Of course, that intensity, that is always a big question. That will continue to be a question with this. If this just ends up being a moderate tropical storm, obviously much different than if we're talking about a hurricane. But at this point, we are talking about a moderate tropical storm working its way into the Gulf of Mexico, potentially over the weekend. So we're going to continue to watch this and watch for all those little changes as we go through the next several days. We'll keep you updated right here on MyFoxHurricane.com.